I'm talking to Julian Macharia, who's responsible for the business development of Boonie Media. What exactly is Boonie Media?
Well, Boonie Media is a company, a media, multimedia organization, and we have various products and divisions, if you may say, in the organization. So one of the things, Boonie Media was incorporated, and one of our flagship projects was the XYZ Show, which is a political satire show. Then we went into Boonie Publishing, and what we do is usually do publishing of books, especially cartoon caricatures, because a lot of the people who are on the board are actually editorial cartoonists, so we also compile a lot of their works, and that's how they came together even in the first place, just to form this organization. We also do documentaries, we do animations, and we also are working on various other multimedia-based projects. Our most recent venture is Boonie TV, which is a web and mobile-based distribution platform, because as content producers, one of the challenges we're facing is getting our content out there and being able to control it all the way to the end, basically where no one is asking for editorial control or demanding for it to be played out in a certain way. So we felt that that was lacking. More so, we felt that there's so much great African innovative content out there that does not have a place to be seen. So you find in Africa, maybe if a big movie, a theatrical release, will only be shown in maybe what 50 theaters across the continent, and yet we have such a big population, probably over a billion now, and there's nowhere to get this content. So one of the things Boonie TV is trying to do, it's going to be a hub where you can also get all our content and also other content that we feel is interesting, that is of high quality and is very innovative.
Okay, could you give a few examples of other content that you're distributing?
Yes, what we are distributing, we have content that is coming from South Africa, Morocco, Egypt, Ghana. We even have stuff from other parts of the world, because at Boonie TV, the content we look for either is done by Africans, is about Africa, produced in Africa, or that has content that is similar to social or economic issues that are facing Africans. So if we find something interesting, for example, in India, we have content from there. We feel that a lot of the challenges they face are also, we can relate to them. So as long as it's something that Africans can connect to and possibly also learn from them.
As long as it has some affinity with the issues Africans
are facing. Absolutely, yeah. Or it's entertaining and we feel that there'll be some connection. If the storyline would augur well with our audiences, will get it.
Exactly. Oh, and what does this tell us about your main audiences? I had assumed that since Boonie TV is online, it would have been more diaspora audiences, or is this, am I mistaken?
Yes, for one thing we are trying to focus on is, of course, Boonie is available worldwide because it's online and on mobile. But one of the things we are doing, we are trying to create a place where, a universe, an environment where Africans can go and find this great content, because it's very difficult to find this stuff. And also what we're trying to do is also be a curator. So we are aggregating excellent content and also curating. So we're also going to start going really way back to find all the rare pieces and films that were done and you don't know where to get it anymore. And we're also going to be able to have it available on Boonie TV. So for us, our target audience definitely is Africa. And even if you leave Africa and leave, you're just in a different location. But we are targeting primarily the Africans. And that's why it was very important for us to be mobile ready from the time we launched. You find other companies launch online, then go mobile. For us, we actually probably like started mobile first. And one of the things we've done, we've optimized Boonie TV to play on multiple handsets, from feature phones to smartphones, tablets, laptops. We anticipate that any device that can play back video, you will be able to watch Boonie TV on it.
And if you started from the outset thinking mobile, does that mean that you're also producing and or distributing content that is specific for the mobile screen, for the small screen?
Yes, what we have is our website has been optimized for devices. So it's an intelligent, works with an intelligent algorithm. So if you log on from a tablet, there's a way Boonie TV displays on your screen. If you take it from a 2x2-inch phone, there's a way it modifies itself to fit your for your phone. So that's something our developers did on the back end. So it's an intelligent website. So basically it doesn't matter if you use a big screen, 14-inch, it'll give you more higher resolution, and so it's scalable. So okay. It's designed to accept all formats. So everyone has experiences based on your device.
Okay. And what's your pricing approach?
At the moment, Boonie TV is free. So all our content is basically free to view. But later on, we'll probably have a subscription model. And that's something that's still in development. But right now, our focus is to get the content there and to build a community around the the channel, and then later on is when now, because of the cost of licensing certain types of content, so certain content you may require to pay, but we'll always have content that is available free.
Yeah, free bit and then a premium
model.
Okay.
Yes.
And let's talk a little bit about content production in Africa or here in Kenya, as you like. How do you see it evolving? What's the trends these days?
One of the trends, I would say, speaks specifically for Kenya, but even based on my exposure, it's definitely driven by the public. People are on social media now. People are trending on Twitter. People are on Facebook. So you can no longer create something just from an idea. It's no longer just an idea in your mind where you say, I had this great idea for a movie. Now you have to run it by a couple of people. You have to better test it, possibly do a pilot, do focus groups, because if you're not careful, I mean, people can kill your show even before it ever takes off from the first episode. A few people trend and say that show is boring, you're done. So you have to be very in touch with the people. You have to keep seeing what are people looking for. And before you go into any space or play into any type of genre, you have to see the kind of reception. So if before you do a horror or a thriller movie, you have to assess how have the other thrillers performed. What is it people didn't like? What is it people like? And like for us, when we are developing our content, for example, the XYZ show, sometimes we just go outright and ask people, what do you want to see on this week's show? Or after every show, as the show plays, we ask people to go on our Twitter handles and tell us, what do you like about the show? What don't you like? And what it starts doing, it starts allowing us to be organic. So the audiences begin feeling they're a part of the show. So if you give a suggestion and, for example, we created a whole skit out of your suggestion, we build the affinity because you do realize we are listening to you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it's very important. It's a future. Yeah. No longer will you just do the where you'll go on a hunch and just say, let's just do a really great film. Now you really have to monitor trends and also see what's the mood on the ground.
Mm-hmm. So I hear that there is a lot of market research that you're doing, and you're also a very community inclined.
Absolutely, absolutely. The world is getting smaller, and people are being driven by social prompts. And that's why you're seeing the emergence of things like Google Plus. You'll buy a product, check out something if more of your friends liked it. Because since you already share common values and interests, there's a higher chance you probably like what they want. Because also what's happening in the world, there's just too much to choose from now. There's no time to sift through everything. And that's one of the things we also want to do with Buni TV. We want to take the work of sifting through all the content that is coming out and only make sure the best is what gets onto Buni TV. So we'll guarantee there's nothing boring on Buni TV. When you come there, you'll be able to spend hours on it. Whatever you watch will be an experience.
So when you say the best, you mean the thing that most of all you know that your audiences are gonna like and gonna engage with?
Yes, more so what our audience is like, but also the best in terms of the quality and something that is unique.
You mean because, quality in terms of technology?
Yes, the quality, there's also the production values and then the quality in terms of the storyline. So it has to be something interesting, not a story that has been told 20, 30 times in different ways.
You want
ways.
To differentiate.
That's the thing. We want to be a premium channel where when you go there, you're assured of high quality content.
Okay. Yeah. And if you say that people make suggestions, has it ever happened to you that somebody saw something on the news and said, oh, if you could do this in the XYZ show, or if you could do this in a cartoons, like plug ideas to you and then you follow up on that?
Absolutely. In fact, that's the kind of dance we have with our audiences. And what tends to happen, like in Kenya, we are famous for our scandals. So when a scandal breaks on the news, by 20 minutes after the bulletin, people start saying, oh, wait, I can't imagine what you guys will do with this. And some people even give a top-line synopsis and say, what if we see the president doing this? And of course, we take all the feedback. And once in a while, we actually do get very interesting ones. And we go full production on them.
Okay, that's very cool. You're going to have to start paying commission to your audience.
I know.
Okay, well, thank you very much for our chat, and I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
Thanks.